ISUPK.
They try to tell me I can't win, all because of the skin I'm in. But then I look in the mirror again, and then we realize we better than them, we better than them.
They divided and they conquered my kin, but separated by the pigmentation of our skin. It's just that white supremacy agenda again. They want your mind in gold, cutting sugar cane, turning cotton gins. We left the plantation, then they pushed us into tenements. Police patrolling, hunting all my people like we're venison. The government's the criminals, they the real terrorists. Moving more coke than a Cuban watching pelicans. Selling all the dope, trying to kill us with the medicine. You a slave if you think that we're American. America was great before the pilgrims had a settlement. Trump gets in office, blacks uniting with the Mexicans. Black, Hispanic, Haitians, Jamaicans, we all relatives.
Good day, Port of Spain. We are the ISUPK. Out on 125th Street, Harlem, New York. Under Commanding General Johanna. We are not affiliated with any Christian group. We are not affiliated with any Muslim group. We are not affiliated with Rasta City or Muslim. We are not affiliated with any Hindu group. We are not affiliated with any Christian-like group on the face of the planet. Today, our topic is going to be the ISUPK helps and corrects our people. Good. Just like in times past, when the earth was getting sinful and the Lord was getting ready to bring his great works in, like in the time of Noah with the flood, like in this time, which is the last days, because you're seeing all the signs of it, he sent his prophets to warn the people about the lifestyle, about the things that is going to come next, about you getting yourself ready. And today we are only here to address blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians. Right. Who are the lost 12 tribes of Israel?
Right.
Who are the Lord's people?
Right.
So as we out here today to let our people know what is required of them in this time, because as we know, in this time you're going through a lot of oppression. You would see the oppression that we people going through when we try to get a little justice, when we try to get a little peace, how we are oppressed by the heathens, oppressed by every nation upon the face of this earth.
Right.
So we're here to speak to our people, east, west, north, and south.
The book of Psalms, chapter 82 and verse 3. Defend the poor and the fatherless. Do justice to the afflicted and needy.
We are here to defend the poor and the fatherless.
Right.
All them fatherless youths and them in the ghetto, that is what we here to do.
Right.
To be an example as young people to we brothers and sisters. We defend the poor in the ISUPK.
Deliver the poor and the needy. Rid them out of the hand of the wicked.
We here to ready out of your hand of the wicked. To let you know what you're supposed to do to stay out of the way of the heathen.
Right.
To let you know what you're supposed to do to live a righteous life. To let you know what you're supposed to do to take care of your families the right way. Not robbing and stealing and putting up yourself so that the heathen could get to execute you.
Right.
Word.
Deliver the poor and the needy. Rid them out of the hand of the wicked. They know not, neither will they understand. They walk on in darkness. All the foundations of the earth are out of course.
Hold it right there. The Lord say, know not, you walk along in darkness. All the foundations of this wicked earth is out of course.
Right.
Nothing is how the Most High say it's supposed to be in this world.
Right.
You cannot trust the Christian church, the marrying gays in the Christian church.
Right.
It's Bikini Pageant in the Christian Church.
Right.
Right across here in the Catholic Church. 270,000 child abuse cases in the Catholic Church.
Right.
I can't even trust to carry my little child in the church because there's wickedness in high places.
Right. I have said, ye are gods, and all of ye are the children of the Most High.
Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians are the gods on this earth.
Right.
The rightful gods on this earth. But because we fall away from keeping we father's laws, from keeping we father's customs, the punishment that he put on us is put us to the bottom.
Right.
But I'm telling you, black man, once we come back to the laws, statutes, and commandments, and customs, and get to learn them in the ISUPK, we will be the gods of this earth again.
Right.
So this is what we have to understand. How long will we continue living a sinful life and being at the bottom? How long will we continue to take oppression from the nations? 400 years we people getting oppressed in slavery, and today on news you see a case where a young black man went strolling through the forest with whites and they nearly lynched him. After 400 years, black man, your ancestors was died for you in all manner of ways. Some of them was fed to alligators. Some of them was thrown off the slave ships. And so easily, you forget 400 years of oppression and trusting in the oppressor. Are you crazy? Wake up, my people, wake up.
Right.
Because you're sleeping a deep sleep. These nations are not our friends. The children of Israel, the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians, we stand alone.
Right, right.
We are the chosen people of God.
Right, right.
Everybody else outside are the nation of Israel. The Lord called them heathen in the Bible.
Right.
And I don't care who get offended by it. Who get offended, where it fall, it fall.
Right.
Go ahead.
The book of 2nd Ezra, chapter 2 and verse 22. Keep the old and the young within thy walls, whosoever.
So we job today is to keep the old of our people and the young of our people inside our walls.
Right.
Because inside our walls there's safety.
Right.
There's safety in the ISUPK. Because the time that we have is doing the work of the Lord.
Right.
I don't have no time to join Rasta City. I don't have no time to join Muslim.
Right.
I don't have no time to do no foolish things that gonna make it easy for the heathen to murder me.
Right.
I here doing the work of the Lord.
Right.
And if you want to kill me or oppress me for doing the work of the Lord, so did they.
Right.
To Jesus Christ, who we know is Yahweh in Hebrew.
Right.
So they did to Paul. Many times he made prison. So lock me up. I don't care. As long as it's for the right thing.
Right.
So this is what we have to do today.
The book of Psalms, chapter 91 and verse 7. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand. But it shall not come nigh thee.
What it right there? The Lord say 1,000 will fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come near thee.
Right.
The pestilence that the Lord pouring out on the people today for not keeping the laws, statutes, and commandments does not harm any man, woman, or child in the ISUPK.
Right.
Wants to walk in, or the Lord wants you to walk.
Right.
We're not involved in no gang. While we're doing the work of the Lord, we just hear we brothers getting murdered. While we're doing the work of the Lord, we just hear pregnant women getting shot.
Right.
While we're doing the work of the Lord, we just hear we people running left, right, and center, dodging bullets, in Port of Spain. Make some value of your life and serve the Lord.
Rule!
That's right.
That is the only thing you're supposed to be doing. Your life is not your own to do foolishness with it. Come into the ISUPK, learn the proper breakdown of the Bible, and serve the Lord.
See, like it. The book of Psalm 91, verse 8. Only with thine eyes shall thou behold and see the reward of the wicked, because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation.
We make the Most High our habitation. The Most High's work is our habitation.
Right.
We don't get caught up in foolishness. You don't find brothers in the ISUPK being tricked by the heathen to sell drugs.
Right.
You don't find brothers in the ISUPK being tricked by the heathen to do all the dirty work.
That's right. Right.
Put up in the front line like pawns.
And it's bad.
How long will we let the heathen use us? How long do we say a black man is a big drug dealer?
Right.
When we know the black man don't have no money to bring in no drugs.
Right.
You understand? We know all the racists who is the big drug dealers in Trinidad and Tobago.
Right.
What is your life worth? A few coins? A Jordan? A gold chain? What is your life really worth?
The book of Zechariah, chapter 11 and verse 5. Whose possessors slay them and hold themselves not guilty. And they that serve them say, blessed be the Lord, for I am rich. And their own shepherd pity them not.
Right, who possess us, slay us, and pronounce themselves not guilty. Today, all the heathens slay us and pronounce themselves not guilty.
Run.
Again and again and again. No justice for the people. The father and the slain pregnant woman in the Beetham come up and begging on the TV. He say he want the commissioner to talk to him. You understand? The day of the funeral, he come up and say the commissioner went to a football game and never come and see him. Why do we continue to look for comfort from the heathen?
Right.
From our oppressors?
Right. Right.
Why do we continue to do that when you're not seeking comfort from your own people?
Right.
Look, your people out here today screaming out the lungs for you to come on their side.
Right.
And get comfort in the ISUPK.
Right. Right.
You will walk past them straight, but you will go on national TV and beg for comfort from the heathens.
Right.
These people were not designed to comfort you.
Right.
They were designed to test and oppress you.
Right.
Your comfort is in the Lord. Your comfort is in the law, statutes, and commandments.
Right, right.
Your comfort is with your brothers in the ISUPK.
Right.
The book of Zechariah, chapter 5 and verse 6. For I will not more pity the inhabitants of the land, saith the Lord. But lo, I will deliver the man, every one, into his neighbor's hand, and into the hand of his king, and they might smite the land. And out of their hand, I will not deliver them. Verse 7.
So again, my people, stop looking for comfort from heathens. Stop it. I'm talking to my people here today. There is no comfort in heathens. Stop putting yourself with a woman and looking for comfort. Stay with your black woman. Stay with your Hispanic woman. Stay with your native Indian woman.
Right.
Because the Lord said when you pour yourself for them, they will become snares and traps unto you. Stop looking for comfort from the heathen.
Yes. Book of Psalms, chapter 58 and verse 3. The wicked are estranged from the womb. They go astray as soon as they are born, speaking lies.
Hold it right here. So the Most High let them, you know, the wicked go astray from the womb. And the wicked he talking about is you heathens. And he say, as soon as you're born, you speak lies.
That's right.
So why should the children of Israel trust people who the Lord say going to lie from the birth? Why do we continue to trust in them? Trust in your own.
Right.
Who is the last 12 tribes of Israel today?
Right.
The book of Psalms, chapter 58 and verse 4. Their poison is like the poison of a serpent. They are like the dead adder that stoppeth her air, which will not hearken to the voice of charmers, charming never so wisely.
Holiday. So the Lord is comparing the heathens to a snake, and it's saying, no matter how you try to charm it or try to bring peace to it, it will not hear your cry. So crying to these heathens does not make any sense.
Good.
Father, on the beaten, if you are looking at me now, I can feel your pain. But looking for sympathy from heathens, the Lord let you know they're like a snake, the ass clog.
Right.
Right.
It will not help you. It will not bring comfort to you.
Right.
What will bring comfort to you is joining your people and keeping the laws of the Most High.
Right.
And living how He wants you to live. Not begging for the heathen, oh God, come down and see me and talk to me. He playing football. He only say he was coming and talk to you because he had camera, he had TV.
Right.
So he tell you that. A promise is a comforter, fool, like old people let's say.
Right.
Too much promises. We as a people like to listen to from these heathens. Our Native American brothers get almost 400 promises. A peace from their oppressor. And the oppressor never keep one.
Right.
So stop looking for comfort from them.
Right.
They are incapable of loving the children of Israel.
Right.
It is not in their DNA to love the children of Israel.
Right.
Understand that, Border Spain. Understand that, children of Israel.
Right.
The book of Proverbs, chapter 21 and verse 13. Whoso stop his ears at the cry of the poor, he also shall cry it himself, but shall not be heard.
The day coming, blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians, all these heathens who stop their ears to be Christ, they will not be heard when the Most High return.
Right.
Because the Most High let you know in the book of Revelations, he that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity.
Right.
He that killeth with his sword must be killed with his sword.
Right.
Judgment is coming to you heathens.
That's right.
The fury of the Most High is coming to you heathens.
That's right.
Justice is what we need. And to get justice, you have to come into the ISUBK and learn how to serve the Lord.
Right.
Because the Christian church can't teach you that.
That's right.
They could only teach you about marrying homosexuals.
That's right. Good,
good. They could only teach you about bikini pageant in the Christian church.
Good, good.
They could only teach you about molesting young children like in the Catholic church. That's all they could teach. Sin and wickedness.
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 10 and verse 25. Pour out thy fury upon the heathen that know thee not, and upon the families that call not on thy name.
All right, eh? Lord say, pour out thy fury on the heathen who know you not. You think they know you? They don't know you. They know about making money. They know about getting higher than you. They know about oppressing you. They know about giving you the low jobs and having you working Sunday to Sunday, so you can't even spend time with your family. That is what them know. Making money off of you. You just like a can of coke. Drink the liquid inside and throw it in the can.
Pour all thy fury upon the heathen that know not thee, and upon the families that call not on thy name. For they have eaten up Jacob, and devoured him, and consumed him, and has made his habitation desolate.
Right? Jacob, who they're talking about here, represents the lost 12 tribes of Israel. Today, that's who Jacob would be today. The blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians.
Right.
And they have left our habitation desolate.
Right.
Where you think you're seeing so much of my brothers, some ash down here for? Because they leave the habitation, the place of living, desolate. That you can't even be comfortable in your own home. It's the same thing the white man do to us in slavery. That way we all across the world. He take we from me home and scatter us. And we in the land and we oppressor being oppressed.
Right.
The Native Indians, the same thing they do. Take away the land from them. Have them living in a small little piece of land. While the oppressor are enjoying their land.
Right.
It's time for us to get ourselves organized.
Right.
Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians. Let go of the wickedness of the heathen. Heathens, all them Venezuelan women that came down here, they exploit them as soon as they reach.
Right.
And encourage them to be whores.
Right.
We men, they just encourage them in being homosexuals. It's time for we to let go of the nasty, stinking ways of the heathen.
Right.
And pick up the ways of the Most High God.
Right.
Because in this book, all the laws, the statutes, the commandments, the customs, right here.
Right.
But you cannot learn it in the Christian church.
That's right.
You cannot learn it in the Muslim mosque.
That's right.
You cannot learn it in Rasta City.
Right.
And Muslim.
That's right.
And unruly ISIS.
Right.
So come with your brothers. And let's keep these laws. And bring back our King, Yahweh Shai, who the world knows as Jesus Christ.
Right.
Go ahead.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 23 and verse 17. There shall be no whore of the daughters of Israel, nor a sodomite of the sons of Israel.
Don't let no heathen encourage you and be no whore.
Right.
Selling your body so you can get rich.
That's right.
So you can get HIV and can't see about your children. Black woman, Hispanic woman, Native Indian woman, wake up.
Right.
You are the daughters of Zion.
That's right.
Let no heathen encourage you in foolishness.
Right.
Come back to God's laws, statutes, and commandments. We need our sisters in the ISUPK.
That's right.
To help push this work.
Right.
We need our brothers in the ISUPK to help push this work.
Right.
We cannot do it alone. Join with your nation and help save your people.
Right.
From certain destruction.
Right.
In the world.
The book of Leviticus, chapter 18 and verse 22. Thou shalt not lie with mankind as with womankind. It is abomination.
Sodomy is an abomination. Being effeminate in the Christian church is an abomination.
Right.
These men in the Christian church, they can't die for you. Let me be real. Big mountain.
That's right.
Let me be real.
Right.
Come out of the effeminate Christian church with right. The white image in it.
Right. That's
and
right.
Come and join your black brothers. And keep the Lord's culture.
That's
keep
right.
Your culture.
That's right.
Not dress up in no shirt with your pants pulled up high, high above your waist.
Right.
And you represent nothing.
Right.
Come and join your people, your culture.
The white man is the devil, our history is evidence. Coons say I'm racist, by definition I'm prejudiced. Got a right to be hesitant, as the African Methodists. We the endangered species, they'd rather protect the elephants. We the sons of God, like a seraphim. God chosen people from the Old and New Testament. Black power, Kwam Yasha Allah, black excellence. We your new rulers, bow down to your eminence.
They try to tell me I can't win, all because of the skin I'm in. But then I look in the mirror again, and then we realize we better than them, we better than them.
They try to make you think rich, Why?
To make your whole life a big risk.
So what you do?
Commit a crime, get locked up, come home, can't get a job. Man, that shit just make you think bricks.
They trapping you.
Ain't no way out of this poverty. Fuck being the prodigy, cause the world say you ain't shit. And then they give you religion. As soon as all that fails, they like to make you feel it ain't this, it's you. So what you do, you just can't get it right. Yeah, they like to say the truth hurts, but watch me take a life. And they like to keep you in darkness so you can't get the Christ. Not knowing like Jacob's sons, he is real light. Get it? So